Hello, Mr. Creeper. Mr. Creeper, hi. Hey, Mr. Creeper! Creeper! Hi. Give me a hug. Give me a hug. I miss Rollo. Give me a hug. Mr. Creeper, if I break the glass, will you kill me? Mr. Creeper, if I break the glass, would you kill me? Look how close I am to the creeper! Oh my god! Jerox here. Welcome back to the other episode of the Outcast Survival Server. Guess where I'm at? You probably guessed it from that giant whale in the background, but I am currently on my base. That's right, we put a roof on it. In our last live stream, make sure to go check it out. It was boring, but it was actually, we did put a roof on it. With some input from, our Viking friend, aka Rowan. So yeah, she came over last night. She helped me out. It was kind of a mutual helping. I helped her, she helped me, you know. It's kind of like a mutual thing. Depending on whether I should put cobblestone along here. In here, because it's looking kind of like bland up here. Then again, looking at the general. Oh god. Woo! Okay. What a start to the episode. I swear. That was a start to remember. Heh, my dog's just staying there. But yeah, we're gonna be, possibly, I don't know what we're gonna be working on, but that's one of the ideas. I'm thinking about either working on a villager tree. It has something to do with my villagers. Because, first of all, the villager breeder stopped working, and I think I know why. But that's an easy fix. I just gotta get one of these guys in the hole. There we go. Alright, it should be good. I definitely should be putting carpet down on top of these so that way I don't have to worry about all that stuff. I do have wool on me, and I can make carpet. So, if I do this right. Yep. Okay. Well, we can now get into pro method. We don't have to worry about building over it anymore. Okay, well, that's all taken care of. We got a village in a hole. That's good. But now, we got this huge open area in front of our base. Where this village used to be. Because, it was never on camera. Although it should have been, but me and Rowan basically tore down this entire village. Don't know who Rowan is, he's also known as Aussie Blaze. Very awesome person. Go check out her channel. I'll make sure to leave her link in the description of this video. So you guys can go check out her Outcast live streams. I mean, she's doing a pretty good job. I'm not really gonna go over to her base. That's for you guys to know when you guys go watch her streams. So I'm not really going to head on over there. But we're just going to be doing some basic things around here. Like, I did go mining. I got plenty of iron, so now I got mine carts. So now, alright, I got 12 mine carts. Actually, I can make another mine cart. Alright, so I forget how many mine carts we got. We got a good amount of mine carts. Now, we're going to need a dispenser. We're going to need rails. Which, I think... I got iron here. I might need some powered rails, mostly, but... Right, powered rails, regular rail. Okay, that was the gift chest that Eminem gave me. Let's see here. I just used up all my iron. Jerox a noob. Wow, he is such a noob. But I need to figure out a good design for my villager breeder. So, not villager breeder, but my... you guys know what I mean. My villager trading hall. Ooh, another minecart. Ooh, another minecart. Ooh, a few dispensers. So I actually need one dispenser. I'm gonna need quite a few bits of redstone as well. So I want to check out my other chicken. Wow. You were supposed to stand guard! You were supposed to stand guard! Why? You let them know my secrets! No! Oh my god! Are you serious? The pranks have only begun. Alright, I know who that was, so by the way. It was a newbie. It was Eminem. We're gonna get him back. Right before we start anything. And I think I have an idea on what we could do. So, one time, a creeper blew up, like, right underneath me. I didn't even see it. We're gonna put a creeper proximity mine right outside his base. So we gotta find a creeper. First of all, I need a shovel. I can get a shovel, but it's almost broken. I guess for now we're gonna work on our villager hall. But let's see here. I'm probably gonna put the villager hall like over here. Somewhere away from the villager baiter. So most likely, it's gonna be probably right here. So I guess for right now, we're gonna go to our testing world, just so we can like figure out what we're going to do. I'm probably gonna have to transport them by boat most likely, but when they get over here, we're gonna be putting them in minecarts and sending them up into their individual trading posts. So I'll see you guys in the testing world. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are in our testing world. So, yeah, let's get to building this villager trading hall. So, what we're basically going to need, if we're going to go off of the same design palette as our base, we're most likely going to need polished andesite, some stone brick, if I can find it. Where are you, stone brick? I need stone brick. There you are. I'm probably gonna use some cracked stone brick too, just to add to the intensity. We're also gonna need our mine carts. We're gonna need our powered rails and our regular rails. So let's get building this thing. So I'm probably going to have it maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, I'm gonna make it maybe 7 blocks long. Maybe like something like almost like an eye, maybe. As you guys can tell, I have no idea what I'm doing. Like, I'm just trying to figure a few things out. Alright, so / leather clear. Alright, so actually, no. We're gonna make like 5 blocks. That's 4. There we go. Oh, this is so unproportional. Fixed it. Time to get with my block placement, please. Okay. So we're gonna have like individual chambers or whatever. So I'm guessing what I'm thinking is like having the villagers come in like this part here. Probably gonna go up maybe like 50 blocks, so not 50, but maybe 30. 14, and drop 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Crap, I guess that's 20. 30. Maybe have this tall? Maybe? Yeah, because like, if I'm going off of like, yeah. We're sort of like a medieval palette kind of thing, I guess. I don't know. Okay, so build up right here. It's kind of boring, but this will probably be time lapsed. Okay guys, well we got our walls in. Now, we're going to get our floors all settled. So, this design mostly made by, actually, I could say it's a design sort of by them, but I'm trying to make it my own kind of design in a way. Actually, you know what? I'm thinking. Actually, I'm gonna need some poppers too. So, let's get some hoppers. And what I'm actually thinking about doing is dropping a villager into like a pod. So, like, when the villagers drop in, they'll be like trapped. So let's see here. So the villager is gonna come across here and just gonna keep on dropping down until it's built. So alright, yeah, so like here's the water column. Maybe have like a slab on top of here, maybe? I'm still trying to figure this out. This is why it's a creative testing world. So maybe like, actually no, I'm just gonna have a bottom half slab here. Because villagers still can't get out. And then have this right here. Yeah, so like the villagers would be in like little pods like this. So I'd be able to like, I think you'll still be able to trade with them, I think. If I get a villager egg. Can't remember what the egg looks like. Got hit looking through a creative inventory. Here we go. So like, hey, put a villager here. Ooh, nice. 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 But I think if I put like a floor like right here, like you'll still be able to trade with them. Yep. Leatherworker, Leatherworker, Armor, Cleric, Librarian. I mean, I'm probably gonna like, I'm gonna have signs also indicating what trades that you have, but so far that's what the breeder's gonna, well, that's what it's gonna look like mostly. Let's not have it like, I mean, they still can't get out anyway. Actually, let's have it all the way open. Let's have it all the way open. Yeah! But if we don't like it, we can just drop it in like lava, maybe? Alright, so... So maybe... or we can just see it's like a bottom half slab here. Or maybe a top half slab. I don't know yet. But they're clear. Cause like, if I don't like the villager, I'm probably gonna drop him in lava. Just in case, so like... So I'm gonna have lava like right here. So maybe have like a little killing chamber right here. Below each villager. So here, 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 and here. We'll have killing chambers. We'll put lava in every single individual chamber. And if we don't like the villager, we'll just... look at the redstone like on the other side here. With the pistons and such. Yeah, okay, so... We have to put that away. For now, let's get a lava bucket. First off, I'm gonna have to... I can get these villagers back, it's no biggie. Nope, don't want that. Okay, so... Yeah, so like, if I don't like the villager, I can just, Yeah, I can just, like, put him in a hole and let them die. Basically playing God with villagers. So that's pretty much what one individual row is most likely gonna look like. Okay, so... We have this here. So, probably gonna have a sticky piston extended. Alright, so... Where can I get a sticky piston in here? Most likely, right here. Alright, so... Sticky piston. Now the rest is most likely gonna come, or actually, it's gonna come underneath the villager and then coming out behind him. Cause like, I'm still gonna have the floor right here. The floor is still gonna be like right here. So like, I probably have like a, like maybe like a button behind each one here. So like, let's get a wooden button here. So I'll be able to press that. And the villager will drop into lava and die, basically. So, what I'm going to do here is, actually, I can see some, like, wool for this one, probably. Just to indicate what each one is. I'm still trying to get better at redstone, guys. Okay, so, lime for now, I guess, so. So, we got that. So, what I'm going to need is a redstone torch. Now we'll activate it. That deactivates it. Okay, so we can do that. Okay, so now, if I put a torch right here, it'll deactivate it. Redstone torch here. It activates it. And then I'm gonna have that signal going probably down one into here. Coming out behind here. So, I wonder if I put a redstone dust I'm terrible at redstone, by the way, so I'm still trying to test this, so that obviously powers it. If I put a torch here, will that deactivate it? Okay, so that deactivates the torch. Okay, so... Redstone torch here, redstone torch here, redstone torch here. So, as of right now... That piston needs to stay powered. I do this right, one second. We get a villager real quick. I can just do a slash villager. Come on. Villager. Oh, I see. I gotta put the piston in one closer. Piston actually needs to go like right here. That's okay. Alright. Here we go. Alright. Some dust. So now we put a villager in here. Alien armor? No, thank you. Oh, it's powered because of the redstone torch. Okay. Okay, so if we. Okay, so we know that's not gonna work. This line needs to stay powered. So I'm gonna put redstone torch here. Block above it. Redstone torch deactivated. Ledger 274. I hereby sentence you to death. Gotcha. I figured it out. It was actually really dumb. I can't figure out my key bindings, but it was awkward. But for some reason, I can't use slabs to transfer redstone signal because if I, let's just say, just for example, like this, alright, so. You have your redstone dust going through here. You power this. Your redstone dust. It's not powering. Unless you need something like there to power it. No, yeah, it's not powering. So, I'm not sure if that's like a bug or something, but in 1.13, because I'm in 1.13.2. I'm not sure if it's working, but you guys are seeing this. It's not working. So, the redstone is going to be a little bit more sloppy, but you guys see what I'm doing here. So, like, essentially, I'm going to have villagers come across through here. I'm actually going to repeat this going all the way down. So, yeah, I'll just see you guys when I get done. I just want to update you, let you know that I at least got it. So, unless I just put a button there. A button would probably be more prudent because the button can just come back. Yeah, so if I put a villager here. Let's see, yeah, if I just do this. You guys see though. Of course, now I gotta put pistons on every single one of these, so. Boop, 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 piston, piston, piston. Okay, actually, before I forget, so one button behind H, single, thing. Okay, my fellow peoples of the universe, we have finally gotten the redstone in place. So, if we come over here, this guy is being sent to death. This guy is being sent to death. This guy, I would like this guy, but he's also being sent to death. Sorry, dude. This guy is being sent to death. And last but not least, this guy is being sent to death. Okay, so to basically sum this all off, yeah, the redstone was a mess. Like, seriously, it was absolutely chaotic getting this all set up. Now, to replicate this onto the server, that's gonna take time, especially in survival mode. We're still trying to figure out design stuff for it, so. Like, we still gotta find a way to get the villagers inside these tubes. So one thing we should do is have like tripwire hooks, maybe. Like maybe have Now that's probably a bad idea, but. Like, they can stand right here. I think they're like, because here's our channel in which we're gonna be sending these villagers across. Think about putting some trapdoors, maybe some like iron trapdoors. So if we got some iron trapdoors, we can place them down. Yeah, because they're gonna be coming across here. So maybe. I'm really trying not to break the redstone because, like, yeah, water only flows 8 blocks. I'm guessing maybe it could be like maybe 4 blocks with the first set, have them drop down. Okay, I have an idea on what I'm going to do, so let's head back to the Outcast server to try to figure out what we're going to do here, because honestly, I've been playing Minecraft for too long now. Oh my goodness, it's like, I've been recording this for way over an hour. I'll see you guys back on the Outcast server. Of course, before we actually start building, we gotta like do some terraforming around the base real quick. Oh yeah, we're also back on the server as well. Oh my god, that looks so majestic. I'm still gonna put a flag up there as well. A flag or a beacon, whichever one I get my hands on first. Most likely a flag, because I still gotta fight the wither to get another star. Oh god, this is so loud. This is so loud. So anyway, I'm gonna throw a time lapse this whole thing. And, yeah, go from there. Okay, let me just show you what we got in our building chest over here. As of right now, I got a bunch of supplies that we can be using here, so. We got a bunch of stone brick, and we got a bunch of polished andesite. They're also going to get a redstone too, so in fact, let's head back to the base. Grab a redstone, put it in the chest, sleep. First of all, sleep. Then grab a redstone. And then go from there. Good. In fact, instead of using pistons like I showed in the Freedom World, I'm most likely going to be using those dispensers that I had. Why am I going up to the attic? Yeah. Anyway. I'm probably going to be using dispensers instead of pistons. Just. Or trapdoors. Trapdoors would be good too. Because I'm going to give him a quick jab of lava. Kill him. And go from there. So we're going to get down here. Grab ourselves some redstone. I think that's all downstairs actually. Now that I think about it. I have some redstone. Actually, I'm going to get my dispensers here. Because I have a lot of dispensers that I could use. Also, instead of like iron trapdoors, I'll probably just use regular trapdoors. But still, a way to also, I'm gonna need a lot of buttons as well. Probably use like wood buttons. Since I have a large abundance of them. I don't know what to do. I think I know. I think I have an idea of what I could do. So I'm gonna go outside. If I'm milking in here, I have no idea. Oh yeah, I'm gonna get some torches so I can light that area up as well, too. That's a need. Let's see, here's the good stuff. That's what we need. We're also gonna need our repeaters as well. Yeah. This is why I need shulker boxes, so that way I can actually like have a thing of like redstone items ready to go. So once we get to the end, it'll be like a great. Oh, here we go. Here's some repeaters. There's some good stuff that we need. But also, I don't really. No. So, is our chicken. No, wait, any more chicken? Okay, we do have more chicken here. Good. Wait, a skeleton died in there? What? Okay, yeah, I'm not even gonna ask. All I know is that we have a good amount of chicken here, so. Alright, let's head on over to the area, to the build site. Let's start laying down a bunch of torches as well. So that way we can get along and start constructing this bad boy. Because. Alright, so now that we got this part set up, we're gonna fill in the walls, which that's probably gonna be done off camera. Because, you know, placing these blocks, it's time consuming. It just takes a very, very, very long time. Also, you can see a lot from up here. I was gonna say, can I see where it's based on here? I don't think so, man, but I can see my birch house. The birch house is pretty close. I think Shadow Shade is just over the hill there. I mean, so is Eminem's base as well, which I still gotta do Eminem's the prank for Eminem. So like, I'm probably gonna do this probably off camera, and I'll probably show off like what I've done next episode. Right now, I want to get the prank done for Eminem, because I know for a fact that he's the one who broke the glass in my chicken cooker. So we're gonna create a cheeky little prank that it's basically just gonna create an annoying mess. So I'm gonna get another shovel. Thing is, I need a name tag though, too, so I can, Alright, first of all. What I'm going to do is just go to his base, dig a little area, and hope that creeper spawns down there. Like maybe a 2-block high area. But maybe. I don't know what I'm going to get. You guys will see what I'm going to do in just a minute. I'm going to cut to the part where we're at Eminem's like little fun area. So. Time skip. Thought I'd stop by Xiao Shade's base real quick. And it looks like he was on the server because the items in here are gone. Let's look around his base real quick. Make sure everything's in check. Looks like his hair. Definitely looks like he's been busy over here. Hopefully I'm not spoiling anything, but by the looks of things, he has put his base back together, so I guess that's good. I don't know. I mean, I think he... It may have been him that actually broke the glass. I don't know, but we're gonna head on over. Oh, this is perfect. It's nighttime. So hopefully I can get a creeper in a hole underneath his base. If that will actually work. Or a bunch of zombies. Oh my god, there is so many here. So many mobs around here. Let's see if I can't quickly do this. So. Oh my god, this is perfect. It's a creeper. Yes, creepers everywhere. Yeah, but actually, I don't. That's not really what I need right now. So I'm gonna sleep in the NPA headquarters right now. Then we're gonna dig a hole and put a creeper in it. Run away! They're still burning! They're still after me! Oh, of course they ran to water. Whoa, they're lagging! The lag is real! God! Get in the hole. Get in the hole, creeper! Come on! Okay, well, you're obviously gonna die. That didn't go according to plan. We will get a creeper in this base if it kills me. It should probably will because I suck at dealing with mobs. So I'm gonna see if I can't attract a creeper over here. I mean, there are more creepers in the area. Okay, there's a creeper right over here. Oh, it despawned. Are you kidding me? Why? Why did it spawn? No! Why did you despawn? Wait, what if I get a creeper in a minecart? Would that work? Huh. I don't know. I really don't know. Like, is that even a thing? Putting creepers on my cart and then blowing them up? I know I have no. Oh, what if I? Oh, I just had an idea. Oh my god, I just thought of a genius idea. It's bad though. I'm not gonna do it just yet. I'm gonna wait till later in this series to do that. But I guess for right now, the creeper prank was a bust. Sorry, Eminem. I put a hole in your. Just make sure I'll make sure to leave a link in Eminem to Eminem's channel, and comment on his video saying Jerax did not build or put anything in his area because I did not. All right, I didn't attempt anything. I totally didn't attempt to build anything in his little area. So yeah, with that being said, thank y'all. I will get the villager breeder, not villager breeder, the villager trading hall assembled. Probably most likely off camera, but until that happens, guys, thank y'all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and hope to see another one. So like, comment, subscribe, more content, and just remember, I am always, always, always watching you. Peace out. Bye-bye.